Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about room usage. Remember that old adage in real estate, location, location, location is the most important part? Well, in room acoustics, it's really usage, 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 because what you're doing in the room tells you about the size that you need, the volume that you need, what kind of treatment you need, noise levels, all kinds of issues. So usage of the room is really critical. Let's, to kind of understand a little bit of this, let's think of our room as a glass of water. We have all this energy in the room. We have low frequency, we have middle frequency, we have high frequency energy. So all this energy raises the water level in our room or our glass. Above our head, we can't hear. So it's a way of looking at energy in the room and creating noise, if you will, so that you can't hear certain things. And then we get into all kinds of issues with the amount of energy and the frequency of the energy, especially with low frequency energy. We have long waves of energy that simply won't fit in the room. So they create all kinds of resonances and all kinds of issues that we have to deal with at different locations in the room. One of the locations in the room, especially with low frequency energy, is floor to ceiling. That's an area that's often overlooked, but if you think about it, especially in North America, I think in most areas of the world, that is our shortest distance. So the shortest distance, when it becomes problematic with lower frequencies that are longer and won't fit. So that's an area that you have to be really careful of. So if we look at usage, we look at the frequency and we look at the amount of energy in the room, we know that a vocal room, we have mids and highs that we really have to worry about. Nothing really below 100 cycles. But control, drum, mix, almost every other room, we have full range requirements. So we need to be able to manage and handle all that energy. So that's a good way to look at the differences between requirements. Like a vocal room would not even be close in size requirements to a control drum or a mixing room. So these three here, you know, have way different requirements than a vocal room. So we have to look at usage because the usage determines what we're doing. If it's two-channel listening, if it's home theater, if it's a drum room, just compare and contrast based on your experience the difference in energy requirements between a drum room and a vocal room. So you can see that usage is really, really critical here. So in this graphic, I've taken room volumes and I divided it up into three parts. One part is under 1500 cubic feet. The next part is under 3000 cubic feet. And then the third part is under 4500 cubic feet. That's based on our database and what we've seen as issues in those room volumes. So anything below those numbers, you can see in the red area, it's almost a no-go acoustically because the amount of treatment that you have to put in makes the room so small. Below 3,000, problematic. You can have certain sizes that you can see in the graph there that will work with treatment. And then, of course, 4,500 is kind of a magical number. We see very few issues that aren't easily managed at those volume letters. So usage, usage, usage. Remember that when you're talking about a room, and one size acoustically does not fit all. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, give me a thumbs up so I know that it had value to you. And please, if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section and I'll be more than happy to answer them for you. Alternatively, if there are other topics that you wish to discuss or see discussed in a video presentation, send me an email, info@acousticfields.com, and we'll get them on our list and get them done for you. I release a new video about every week, so stay tuned to our YouTube channel and keep updated on our new videos.